Yep, there it is, people. There it is. This is the mayor of Blacktown. I'm making another video again about this emerging and increasing controversy over gay marriage, the gay lifestyle. And there it is right there. Now, look at that picture. Two white men kissing. Now, I'm showing you this because I know the effect that it has on your mind, black people. And I know some of you, not all of you, but some of you, a few of you think, why are you showing pictures of gay men, gay white men? And you know why you say that? Because you're not accustomed to seeing this. You're only accustomed to seeing the white man being Superman, the white man being Iron Man, the white man being Captain America, the white man being some kind of a heroic figure. Amen? That's what you want to see because that's what you have been accustomed and conditioned to seeing. So when I show, I said, when I show pictures that show the alternative lifestyle, amen, that the white man himself is promoting. Some of you, you're shocked. Yes, you're shocked. But there it is. It's in the headline news every day. President Obama has just declared officially his endorsement of the gay lifestyle, same-sex gay marriage. Yes. Yes. Thereby proving what I have been saying all along since 1998 online. I remember back in 1998, someone called me and told me about a Time magazine cover that said, feminism is dead. After I had been in a debate with some people who are denying and refuting and disputing what I was saying, what I was preaching, what I was prophesizing and predicting, that eventually black men are going to have to man up. We did not come this far for nothing. And we all know what we've been through, hell and high water, since slavery. And even before slavery, when we were on those boats. Yes. So I'm here to say, I told you so, and that's what I'm going to keep on saying, because the evidence is going to continue to emerge that we are in a gender war and that we're in the age of alternative lifestyles, sexual orientation politics, gender politics, alternative lifestyle politics. Yes! Gender war. A war of words. You all didn't believe me. You didn't believe me. A few of you have. A few loyal Blacktown citizens. You know who you are. Yet I'm telling you right now, the mayor of Blacktown has been right all along. Why? Because I do my research. Why? Because I know when God is trying to tell me something. Black man, you are so accustomed to seeing this white man being Superman, Tarzan. And that's partly because, when you were young, you played with white dolls. The black woman, that's what you're responsible for. That's what you have been responsible for. Yes, I have been one of the few black men who has pointed the finger at the failure of the black woman to lead after she deserted our growing black power movement of the 1960s and instead accepted women power and women's liberation and feminism. Yes. I've exposed the black woman's treason, and I've shown how in the Bible, Satan went to Eve the same way. Now, how many preachers in the black church preach the story of Adam and Eve correctly? And I declare that if you don't get the story of Adam and Eve right, how can you get anything else in that Bible right? God help me, this video is going to be real short. I just wanted to show a video that summarizes that we are in the age of gender politics, sexual orientation politics, alternative lifestyle politics. I said we're in the age of gender politics, sexual orientation politics, and alternative lifestyle politics. Maybe some of you all remember the controversy maybe a year ago about the Sesame Street puppets, Bert and Ernie, being exposed for being gay role models for children. Yes, I did a video on that and it was flagged off of YouTube. Because the homosexuals don't like being scrutinized. They don't like it. They're very self-righteous. They want to believe that they're right and everybody else is wrong for not accepting their so-called alternative lifestyle. Nevertheless, the evidence is all around us. You cannot deny it. The evidence continues to grow every day. And now it is epitomized by President Obama's declaration, his controversial declaration and press conference that he gave to the press. And now Newsweek magazine, May 2012, has declared him to be the first gay president. Truth is stranger than fiction. All strong black men, let me hear you say it. Amen.
We declare our right on this earth to be a man, 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 to be a man.